Everyone at Ferguson is committed to strengthening and serving our local communities. Because while the world around us may change, the ideals we stand for will not. We join you in this celebration of integrity, service, and hard work.
Good evening. I am Lee Vreeland, President and CEO of An Achievable Dream. It is my true honor to welcome you to the 28th Annual Tennis Ball, a virtual event. While we had certainly hoped to see you face-to-face tonight, we know that we must adapt and overcome. Challenges become opportunities for new growth, and we are thrilled to bring you an exciting virtual experience tonight. We are incredibly grateful for your support of An Achievable Dream through the changes and challenges of COVID-19. Over the past year, we have been on quite a journey together as the Dream community, but your support has never once wavered. As a team, we have never been stronger. Our students and families remain at the very center of our purpose and mission. And although there is uncertainty, we face the future with hope. Tonight, I hope you will be reminded of the impact of your support. You are not simply supporting education for our students. You are changing the course of history for young men and women for generations to come. You are inspiring hope. From all of us at An Achievable Dream, we thank you.
Good evening, and welcome to the 28th Annual Tennis Ball. I'm Kevin Murphy, CEO of Ferguson Enterprises. On behalf of Ferguson and our 27,000 associates nationwide, I'm truly honored to serve as the chair of this year's event. For many years, we've gathered to celebrate and applaud the efforts of the hardworking, determined young dreamers, several of whom you'll hear from this evening. And we want to thank you for your unwavering commitment to Achievable Dream, an organization that is making a positive difference every single day. Whether this is your first event or your 28th, you know the tennis ball is quite a special evening. Tonight will be no exception. Though the format is different, the mission remains the same. An Achievable Dream continues to change lives and inspire hope through education. Tonight, through our sponsorships, bidding, and donations, we have the opportunity to be part of something incredible. We can make a meaningful difference among the youth and families in our community. Now more than ever, it's imperative that we continue to support organizations like An Achievable Dream as they influence the next generation of leaders and work to bring about greater social justice. Thank you for joining us for the first ever virtual tennis ball event. We hope you enjoy tonight's program, because together we will make a difference.
This evening would not be possible without the support of our sponsors. We would like to thank our premier sponsors, Town Bank, Ferguson Enterprises, Smithfield Foods, and Riverside Health Systems. We would also like to thank the supporters who donated the vehicles and a motorcycle for our premier auction: Casey Auto Group, Priority Automotive, First Team Auto, Hampton Chevrolet, and Hampton Roads Harley Davidson. This evening, we are excited to bring you a virtual tennis ball event. Whether you've gathered safely with your friends for a watch party or are joining us from your couch with a tennis ball in a box party kit, you are helping us to make history. A couple of reminders for this evening. Bidding is all online from your phone or device. You've received instructions for bidding, and our team is ready to assist you with any questions you may have. Bidding closes at 9:15. There's still time to buy raffle tickets before we announce the raffle winner tonight. Raffle ticket sales close at 8:15. You are about to watch a very special program we've prepared for you, during which you'll meet the graduating class, hear from one of our amazing alumni, and hear the story of one of our families. We will also be announcing live the sponsor of the class of 2021, so stay tuned. This year's one we will certainly never forget. And I truly believe this will be an evening we will always remember. Thank you for joining us. Please enjoy your time with your friends or family, or possibly attending the tennis ball for the first time in sweatpants. We hope you enjoy the program. Enjoy your evening and bid high. As a longtime partner of An Achievable Dream, the Rotary Club of the Virginia Peninsula has been instrumental in tennis ball since the very first event in 1992. From helping secure sponsorships and soliciting auction items, to spreading the word about An Achievable Dream far and wide, the Rotary Club members do whatever it takes to ensure the event is a success year after year. We are so grateful to Rotary President Mike Nelson and Rotary Tennis Ball Committee co-chairs Dr. John France and Jeff Britton for spearheading the Rotary Club's efforts this year. Nearly 30 years ago, our founder, Walter Siegeloff, knew the importance of establishing and maintaining strong partnerships and formed a small army of An Achievable Dream supporters, including the Rotary Club members. We are so proud to continue this partnership with the Rotary Club of the Virginia Peninsula. An Achievable Dreams founder, Walter Siegeloff, was someone you only needed to meet once. One meeting told you almost everything you needed to know. He was a force of nature. He never stopped moving and never took no for an answer. And he was incredibly passionate. Spend more than 5 minutes with him and he would probably begin talking to you about an achievable dream. Today, over 7 years after his passing, Walter's legacy is stronger than ever at An Achievable Dream. His dedication and passion for our students lives on in the whatever it takes mentality of our team. We have often wondered what Walter would think about this pandemic. As a leader, I have often asked, what would Walter do in many of the challenging situations we've navigated this year? Well, first, I know he would absolutely hate wearing a mask, but he would do it anyway. He would probably still drive to the office every day, even if the entire team was working remotely. And he would go into withdrawals from not being able to visit his favorite restaurants. But most importantly, he would make every decision for the good of our students and the mission of An Achievable Dream. Walter never lost sight of the vision, and today that vision continues to guide us to a future where all students learn, succeed, and achieve, to a future where equity in education is a reality. So tonight, we raise our glasses from wherever we are to the man who started it all, the man behind the mission, the man who, with or without a pandemic, would have reminded us all, our students need us. Let's keep going. To Walter.
I started out here in the sixth grade. I came here for a fresh start. We were just trying to get out and do something new. And I came here and it was just like, I felt like part of something. I felt like a family. Starting out my high school career, my mom got laid off twice in 1 year. And it was really hard for us. We ended up being displaced and we had to go through a lot of changes. But because of the support that the Achievable Dream has given us, like helping us find a place, helping us just be there and stuff like that, and even where we're staying now, like they're able to work with us and have transportation for us if we need it. I feel like that support has helped us a lot. I never missed a beat because the support system that we had and just allowing us to do what we need to do to get ourselves together and things like that, it really helped to smooth out everything. Because even though we're displaced and where we were living at, I always felt embarrassed about it, and I thought I could never open up about it because I didn't want to be judged. But once they got wind of it, they were like, oh no, we're here to help you. So I really appreciate that because I feel like I'm in a safe space. This is my safe space where I can feel comfortable and not feel embarrassed, and I can just be myself without having to worry about people judging me just because of where I live. So after my mom ended up being laid off twice, she told me that she wanted to go back to school. I felt very proud because And seeing my mom go back to school, that's always been her dream. And she used to always talk to me about that. And she told me that she was going to go to school for being a truck driver. And it made her so excited. It was amazing to see that. So I fully supported her. And once she graduated, she said, in a couple of months, I'm going to start truck driving and doing my new career. But that meant that we had to leave. So we went to go live with my brother's dad in Florida. And when I went there, I didn't get to go to school much because Corona had just started out because I left in February. But being there, it just made me realize that the Shield Dream had prepared me for a lot, because I realized being in Florida that I was ahead. Everybody would ask me, oh, how do you do this? How do you do that? And I just feel like it made me feel like I was a part of something I was just needed. I felt good being able to help others and help others succeed. And that's always been a big part of Achievable Dream. It's like, we're here to help each other succeed. So I brought that to Florida, and that always will be a part of me forever. I'm looking to become an IT specialist, and I'm really hoping that to get my degree and do all things like that, but I'm really looking forward to just using what I can do to just make the world a better place. I feel like being a person who's in this world, there's a lot of things in society that's really messed up. But I want to do something that can contribute to making things better, like technology and hospitals and schools and things like that. I want to be able to make something. Well, the pandemic, of course, has made it hard for a lot of people. But me being in Achievable Dream and me having to move and then come back, I realized that for me personally, it hasn't been that hard, like transitioning from in-person learning to online learning, simply because of the support that Achievable Dream has given us and many students. Some high school students, it gets stressful, so you always feel like maybe I should give up or maybe I should just stop doing it. But here at Achievable Dream, they make sure that you feel needed and that you have everything that you need to be successful so that you can go on into college and do what you have to do to make that career and get your dream job or get whatever you want to do. If I can, I will get my PhD in IT and minor in engineering, and then I will use that to make sure that I can create something that'll help the school. Like, I will come back personally and create some sort of technology. If somebody hasn't made it yet, I would probably make a supercomputer for this place. If I ever need help, I can always call somebody here. If I'm ever in need of something, or just to talk, or just for some advice, I can always come here for it. Whatever you dream about, whatever you want to do in life, it's not impossible. And I can say that because I remember me thinking that because there was a 3.0 club here, I never thought I would get in a 3.0. I never thought that I would get a 4.25 GPA. I never thought I could do that because I know myself, and at the time being when I was displaced and everything was a little bit hard for me, I felt like, oh, maybe I should give up, or maybe I should just keep doing this and not strive for more. But Achievable Dream, this school, I love the school because the support system that they've given me, you can do it. It might be hard and it might be a struggle, but you can do it because nothing is impossible, and that's a fact.
My name is Tasia, and my dream for the future is to go to University of Virginia and major in finance.
Through the pandemic, an Achievable Dream has helped me feel supported.
My name is Tajane, and when I graduate from Achievable Dream, I want to go to Shenandoah University and study for biology.
And Achievable Dream makes me feel welcome.
My name is DeAndre, and my dream for the future is to go to a welding school and become a welding inspector.
An Achievable Dream makes me feel like I can do whatever I set my mind to.
My name is Trey, And when I graduate, I plan to go to the University of Virginia and study visual arts and design.
During the pandemic, Achievement Dream has still made me feel as though I can succeed.
My name is Lena, and when I graduate, I plan on attending North Carolina State and majoring in veterinary science.
An achievable dream makes me feel loved.
Ladies and gentlemen, every year at the annual tennis ball gala, we announce the class sponsor of this year's graduating class. We keep the name of the class sponsor a special announcement for the tennis ball and do not reveal who the sponsor is until the event in the year that that class is graduating. Every year, announcing the class sponsor is a true honor and privilege for me. But there are some years that, because of the long relationship, the complete admiration and respect that I have for someone, and in this case, the person's ability to balance Walter's intensity when he was with us. This person also put restrictions on when Walter was allowed to call him. You see, Walter always got up at 4 a.m. in that time frame. And McKinley can tell you that he thought it was completely okay to call you or text you at that time. But the person that I'm talking about tonight, I think, put a restriction on him that Walter wasn't allowed to call before 6 or 6:30 in the morning. So all of this makes this man extremely special to me. It is with great pride and gratitude that we announce the class sponsor of the class of 2021. Someone who is extremely meaningful to this community and who has changed the path of Newport News forever. He was with an achievable dream from the very beginning. He is someone who is in this room here with us tonight. I know each and every one of you share my excitement when I introduce the sponsor of the class of 2021. PB Mayors is honored to announce that Alan S. Witt is the, in his honor, will be the sponsor of the class of 2021. Alan, will you please join me on stage?
Thank you, dear.
The class of 2021 will forever be known as the Alan S. Witt Scholars. Would you like to say a few words?
Wow. Well, to everyone, to PB Mayors, thank you. You all need to sit down. You know, most of you who know me know that it is rare when I am at a loss for words. So give me a minute to get some thoughts together. Walter Sigeloff was an incredible friend. I can't tell you how much he meant to me, the influence he had on my life, and hopefully to some small extent, I was able to influence him a little bit. I will say, Lee, you got the hours wrong. I get up every morning, and at 5:05, I am on the treadmill with my iPad, and 7 years ago and before, it would start pinging at 5:07.
I was off by an hour.
Yeah.
But I couldn't call you and ask.
Walter was incredible, but his vision and his energy to think that he was at the autumn of his business career, I believe around age 63, when he got the energy and the vision, he got a number of us together, constantly using us as a sounding board and a kitchen cabinet as to how to develop this, and over time, he was just relentless. You know, first with the summer tennis program, then with the elementary school, then with the middle and high school. Beyond that, expanding to an endowment, a foundation, Virginia Beach, up towards Richmond. Just an incredible journey. And many folks in this room and been involved with the Chilwell Dream have done far more than I have, but they know the energy that Walter put behind this. As I have tried to give back to my community, I've always held Walter up as the example of the individual that was relentless in doing so. So tonight I am pleased, and I guess maybe somebody had figured this out. I've heard all types of stories how I ended up with my three sons and three daughter-in-laws here tonight. So I absolutely fell for that. But
two. The team is good. They are.
I know that. It takes a lot to make me look good. They are.
No, that's not true.
But it
does take a lot for CPAs to get mischievous.
No. Well.
And they did it a little too well.
So to my associates, my friends at PB Mayors, thank you so much. This is an incredible honor. Everything that I've been able to be involved in would not have been possible without Debbie being my support, being at my side all the time. There's all types of things that can be said, and behind every man there's a good woman. I think those are old, trite sayings. Mm-hmm. But when you're lucky enough to have a partnership in life that can bring you to certain levels and allow you to do certain things. You are absolutely blessed. So I stand here today telling you that I'm blessed that Debbie has been my partner as I've gone through all these things. I can probably drone on forever, but I won't. Lee, thank you so much for your kind words. Thank Achievable Dream and everyone who's involved. The list goes on and on. So to everyone here tonight, I am humbled. I'm appreciative. Thank you so much. And may this be the first of 28 and 280 and more tennis balls to come.
Well, I may not make it to 280, but I'm going to try. Don't go anywhere yet. I'm going to try hard to make it to like 200.
Okay. Good deal.
Before you go anywhere, we are going to, before we show the video of some of your closest friends, confidants, coworkers, we are going to draw the raffle for tonight, and I'm going to ask that you draw the winning raffle ticket.
You know, you had me do this a few years ago.
I did, yes.
Okay.
Who better than the person that audits you to have them?
Okay.
Yes. Alan, you shouldn't have picked me. That's inappropriate.
Well, I'm so sorry.
No, but you can announce it right here.
So that's Kate Beadle?
Yes, with State Farm. Kate, if you're watching, we may get in touch with you and let you know that you've won. If you're not watching, we will definitely not be contacting you.
Kate, congratulations.
Yes, if you're watching. If not, so Alan, you have been a true mentor to me. I have been blessed to know you for almost 24 years, and I cannot imagine a person who is more deserving than this honor tonight. So it is my great pleasure to always name the class of 2021 the Alan S. Witt Scholars.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. First, I would like to start off by thanking Dr. Rayland for allowing me to serve as your 2020 keynote speaker. Today, I will be sharing my story of how an achievable dream has impacted my life substantially. Originally, my family and I lived on the west side of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, which was a high crime area. So in 2008, my mother made the decision to move my family from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania to Newport News, Virginia for a better life. From the enrollment in fifth grade at Achievable Dream to now as a junior at Virginia Commonwealth University, I've grown in many ways. When beginning the fifth grade at Achievable Dream, I was a very shy and quiet student. Right away, I knew the atmosphere at the school was different. The teachers really cared. They showed us and they told us how much they cared by the willingness to spend extra time to make sure we were successful, and it was a family atmosphere. One of my teachers, Mr. Perry, made it impossible to blend into the background. He helped me come out of my shell. Gradually, I started to see that I could be an example for my fellow students, and in fifth grade, I received the Principal's Award. There was no going back. I had become a dreamer. When I transitioned into sixth grade and attended the same school with middle and high school students, I never felt bullied. I built relationships that became family, relationships that I still maintain to this day. We goofed off together, we learned together, we helped each other with homework, and we always looked out for each other. We still do. As I went through middle and high school, I was faced with many challenges personally, including my grandmother being diagnosed with Alzheimer's. In the years surrounding her illness, my siblings and I served as her caretakers while my mother was at work. It was challenging for us, and there were many difficult days, but I never had a doubt about the support system I had at Achievable Dream. and the comfort of knowing other people understood my situation besides my family. My family and I have always worked extremely hard, sometimes multiple jobs. My mom has always had the spirit of an entrepreneur and has taught me the importance of hard work. And Achieve Your Dream has always been there to support us. It helped make sure we were able to achieve our dreams for a better life. Thanks to the constant support from Achieve Your Dream's administration staff and teachers, I was able to accomplish many things in my high school career, including becoming a member in the 3.0 Club, becoming inducted into the National Honor Society, and in senior year becoming president of my graduating class. One of my favorite things about being class president was that I was able to do things for my classmates and help make our experience together amazing. Entering my freshman year at Virginia Commonwealth University, I felt prepared by Achieve Your Dream. Going into the business field, Achieve Your Dream classes like etiquette and speaking green, which taught us standard business English and public speaking, helped me have confidence in business settings. I attend career fair and business events, and I'm not afraid or nervous to talk to professionals. I know how to make eye contact and greet people with a firm handshake. I am confident in presenting myself and having a social conversation with them. Now in 2020, I have come to utilize many skills and experiences that I've had throughout my years at Achieve Your Dream. After not being able to return to college after spring break due to the pandemic, I was in search of work to help my family out financially. Achieve Your Dream was there to help me secure a part-time job with KC Auto Group. After finding out that all of my classes will be moved to virtual learning, I was seeking permanent job placement. With determination for wanting more for myself and a long-term plan to achieve my goals, I approached my human resources department and expressed my interest in a full-time position. I now have a full-time position at KC Auto Group and am enrolled full-time as a student at VCU. Achieve Your Dream over the years has been there for me physically and emotionally. Most recently, my Achieve Your Dream family and I walked through one of the most difficult times we will ever face with the loss of one of my close friends and graduating classmate, Hector. This loss stunned us all. It is still difficult to speak about because we miss Hector so much. Our lives will never be the same. Throughout it all, Achieve Your Dream has been there with full support. We've cried together, we've shared memories together. There were phone calls to check on how my family and I are doing, and a memorial Zoom gathering where my friends and I were able to share our memories of our friend and reflect on the good times that we all shared at Achieve Your Dream. We got through it together. Achieve Your Dream is not an ordinary school. It is a group of people that have become my family and are always there for me through my ups and downs. I, Jada Lewis, come to you today as a 2018 graduate of Achieve Your Dream, a third-year student at Virginia Commonwealth University studying business marketing and a full-time employee of KC Auto Group. I am a member of the National Society of Collegiate Scholars. One day, I will become an entrepreneur. A few businesses I want to start include a pastry bakery and a financial awareness center for youth. Until then, after I graduate, I plan to work in the marketing field and learn how to market my future products to consumers. After hearing my life's journey within Achieve Your Dream, I hope you see how your support is not just dollars and cents. It is lives changed. It is dreams made achievable. It is a new story for me and my family, one that will change the course of history for my children and grandchildren. This is the difference you make. Thank you.
We became a part of the Achievable Dream family in roughly 2008 when my oldest daughter, Jada, received an invite into the program. And so that's how our journey with the dream first began. I have five dreamers, two of which have graduated, one in 2017, one class of 2020. I have a senior this year, a junior, and a sophomore. Because of socioeconomic challenges that we've had along the way, I've seen each one of my children really come into their own. To see them participate in activities and want to go outside that friend base and be willing to do activities that were asked of them if they were invited to a seminar. They were so eager to go. It was just amazing to kind of see them want to go and do, and also to help. We've always been a family eager to help others, but they really had opportunities within their journey with the Dream to be able to do that, whether it was with school or with peers. I can't say enough about the educators in the building. It's been such a sense of support for each one of my children with the relationships they've built over the years and still maintain. Even my graduates still reaching out to different teachers, seeking advice. It's a family. It's more than just a school. It's more than just a program. It's really a family. Since the pandemic, Achievable Dream has really stepped in providing undying support to our family, whether it's through food or assignments, making sure that internet access is available, that the children are on task and there's no distractions. We experienced a huge setback in our family composition, and the support that we received in that was just overwhelming. I cried because it just, it was such a comfort because it took stressors off that I just didn't think I could deal with. I'm humbled. I just keep saying it, but I'm so humbled to be a part of the Achievable Dream family. Although we all experience financial troubles, that just knowing that whatever they were able to contribute has made a difference and you're able to see it right in front of you, whether it's a chance conversation with one of my children or seeing them in action with something, whether it's through the school or in the community. It's really just, I think it's solidified bridges and has wanted them to continue to support the program, knowing that the money's not just going other places, that it's actually going into the program and into these children, not just into their education, but it's molding them and it's shaping them so that they could really be very productive citizens after they graduate. And I think that that's key. My children are the most amazing children that I could possibly imagine. And part of that goes to an Achievable Dream. We collectively have made a dynamic team. And I see it every day in my children. And when they're out in the community and I see people who are out in the community and they stop me and they say, "You have the best children. You have the most amazing children. You have the most respectable children." It means everything in the world to me because it lets me know that I did my job and I did my job right. And especially following through with their education through an Achievable Dream. Tonight, I implore you to please support an Achievable Dream. This means so much to each and every student and each and every family that is participating in this program. Although we have all faced challenges, whether they're health or financial, I just ask that you please show your support no matter how much, how little, how big, it all counts and it goes a very long way.
Tonight, we are asking for your support. During our Fund a Dream giving initiative, our goal is to raise $25,000 to support an Achievable Dream in Newport News. Our annual operating budget in Newport News is approximately $2.5 million per year. Those dollars provide all of the components you have learned about tonight that help make an Achievable Dream students so successful in school, college, and beyond. Since the onset of the pandemic, your support also helps provide vital resources for our students and their families, including food and hygiene supplies, technology and internet accessibility, clothing and school supplies. Tonight, we need your help to raise $25,000 so we can continue to provide vital services and supplies for students like Selena, Jada, and many more. As one of our AAD parents, Ms. Taylor, shared, for these young men and women, especially during difficult times, an Achievable Dream is the difference in their lives. You can be part of that difference. Will you join us to fund a dream and help us raise $25,000 tonight? Just click the link in your text messages or visit bidpal.net/tennisball2020 to give now. Initiative will remain open for a while longer, so please take time to give. As you've seen tonight, your gift is more than monetary support. You are giving the gift of hope and a future to students and families right here in our community. Quite simply, you are changing lives. We are so grateful that you've chosen to spend your evening with us for a truly unique virtual tennis ball experience. Tonight, we didn't let a pandemic stop us from coming together in support of a mission that we all believe in. We hope you will continue to enjoy your evening, bid until the auction closes at 9:15, and be sure to support the Fund a Dream with your gift tonight. We could not do this without you. Thank you.
There's nothing more awkward than when a video of yourself stops you from talking. So yeah, that was a little awkward. I do want to tell you that we have cameras in your homes tonight for all of you who have watch parties, and we see that a lot of you do not have your cell phones in your hands, and that you are not contributing to Fund a Dream. So before we turn those cameras off, Chief Drew, I'm sure that's not illegal, right, for us to have placed cameras in their homes. So I just want to make sure that everybody gets their cell phones out and make sure that they fund a dream. The last time I checked, we were $2,000 away from our goal for the silent and live. I guess we can't call it a silent auction this year. Of our general and our premier auction this year. So there's one more thing that we're going to do tonight. Alan, I know how much you love a good spotlight on you. I know that that's what you've strived for always. Why are you looking at me like that? I think that's the only time in life that you've given me an evil look. And of all nights tonight, I don't really think that that was appropriate. So, for one last time tonight, we're gonna put the spotlight on you with a video, a tribute video, from those who know and love you dearly.
Alan's legacy is one that is going to live on for generations and extremely difficult to measure. I could spend the rest of this evening kind of talking about all the different things that he's done for the community and how it's impacted it.
I first met Alan Witt almost 50 years ago. I was a very young candidate for the United States Congress in 1976, and I came to Christopher Newport to meet with student leaders. And Alan Witt, even then, was a leader. And he has spent the rest of his life leading, engaging, serving, and making a difference in our community.
Well, for 30 years, Alan has been one of the people most active in our community. So his impact has been widespread and it's been significant.
You know, Alan is a very organized person, so his ability to organize and accomplish what he sets forth is just unbelievable. So whether it's in our business or in the community, which I've seen him do over and over again, he's able to grasp what's needed to be done, organize it, get people to help out, and just, you know, get it done.
His involvement in helping to make the community better in so many different ways, it's hard to single out one way.
Initial impressions of Alan usually result in attributes like he has a keen business mind, is very decisive, or is very well organized. Others may even say he's highly demanding. While all of those are true, I have been even more impressed with things Alan stands for. Strong work ethic, founded on moral principles, honesty, fairness, equality, and justice. In today's world, we need more of Alan.
He has served on so many nonprofit boards, has given so much individually back in contributions to nonprofits, the way he's directed the firm to give back to nonprofits. It's just countless, but the one organization that has always had a special place in Alan's heart is An Achievable Dream. And it's something that he has been a part of since the beginning. He was actually there before there was An Achievable Dream, when it was just this crazy idea in Walter's head. And it's really special for us. We couldn't think of a better way to honor Alan's legacy than to honor the legacy of his dear friend Walter. And so we're super excited to be this year's class sponsors in his name.
Alan has the ability to be big picture minded, more regionally oriented. I think he has the personality to be able to get people to see a vision that we may not be looking at in our day-to-day activities. And I think his future thinking of what's going to benefit the majority of the people is one of his characteristics that I really admire.
Alan has been involved again in many different community endeavors. And I think it, as it fits in with An Achievable Dream, it goes back to the beginning with Walter and some of the great work that was done, you know, 25, 30 years ago, hard to believe. And I think his commitment was to how do we make Newport News a better place to live and work. And one of those ways was to improve and enhance the education system. And I think Alan saw the Achievable Dream as a way to benefit all the kids in Newport News, and that continues to this day.
I was chairman of the Achievable Dream for 10 or 15 years, so I know how much he cares about the Achievable Dream. He sees things that needs to be done, and he's not a sideline type of guy. He gets in and makes it happen.
I think Alan's legacy is leaving an organization that is built on caring about its people and caring about and serving its community. He's always said, find the organization that you're passionate about, go and serve them, and you'd be amazed at just how the connections you make, the relationships you build, the circle of influence that you have, how that comes back to reward you.
You know, I want to thank the partners of PB Maris for the honor that they are giving to their good friend and mine, Alan Witt. I can't think of a more meaningful way to honor him than to the gift that they're giving to the Achievable Dream. It gives me chills, really. And beyond that, the students in the class of 2021 are going to be enriched forever to be known as the class of Alan Witt.
Friends, we want to thank you for tuning in, for coming out tonight to what has truly been an unforgivable evening, our virtual tennis ball.
With your help, we've raised vital support for An Achievable Dream.
That's right, Mary. Without you, An Achievable Dream could not continue to do what we do every day, provide tools, opportunities, and resources to ensure that every child is on a bright path.
From all of us at An Achievable Dream, thank you for your support.
And thank you for dreaming with us.